Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade. Hello, Miss Ryan. I wanted to thank you again for your help with Rookwood and Harlow the day of the troll attack.
Serona, please. And I was happy to help. Oh, those two are nothing but trouble. Glad you and your friend were here when they found you.
I am too. You were speaking to a goblin here that day.
Yes, Lodgok. He's a friend.
It seems as though you were on good terms with him.
I've known him for years. We met when I was waiting tables here as a student, well before I bought the place. He was cordial enough, but we weren't friends then. His mistrust of wizard kind ran deep.
But you're friends now?
We are. I hadn't seen him in years when he came in a few months ago. But he recognized me instantly, which is more than I can say for some of my own classmates. Took them a second to realize I was actually a witch, not a wizard. Not all goblins are like Ranrok and his loyalists. Lodgok is as worried as the rest of us about what's been going on.
In that case, I'd like to talk with him, about Ranrok in particular. Where might I find him?
I assume your interest is to do with the rumors I've heard about Ranrok working with our friend Rookwood.
It is.
If he's not here, you might find him doing business at the Hog's Head. He's a trusted metal trader. You should mention that we spoke. He can, understandably, be wary of witches and wizards. Even ones as young as you. That said, if you're looking for information on Ranrok to help rein him in, you'll find an ally in Lodgok.
You seemed unfazed by Rookwood and Harlow the other day. They don't scare you.
They're bullies. Plain and simple. Never tolerated them in my own life, and certainly won't tolerate them going after my friends. Don't misunderstand me. They're dangerous wizards and shouldn't be trifled with. They should, however, be confronted and reminded, whenever possible, that the rest of us have each other's backs.
Have you heard what Ranrok and Rookwood are working on together?
Not much more than the fact that they seem to have some sort of uneasy alliance. Friendship between wizards and goblins is rare enough, but between those two, they each want something the other has. I can guarantee it. That said, I fear they're like a two-headed serpent. Both will need to be taken down to stop whatever scheme they've been plotting.
Thank you, Serona.
If you find Lodgok, please give him my best. I don't know what you've done to make such powerful enemies, but please, watch your back.
Outside the castle.
You too, Amit.
Welcome to the Hog's Head. Any empty seat is yours.
Revelio.
Revelio.
Can I help you with something?
Hello, Lord Gok. Serona said I might find you here.
She did she? Did she send you with news?
No, actually, I wanted to speak with you. It's about Ranrok.
Now I remember. The three broomsticks. Day of the troll attack. You're the student he's after.
I am. And I need to know what he and his loyalists are up to, so I can stay a step ahead.
Let's say I did know. Why should I trust you?
Serona trusts me, and she thought our interests may be aligned.
Well, if Serona trusts you, very well. I may know of something that could help us both. A way to get Ranrok to confide his plans to me.
I'm listening.
Years ago, a heinous witch stole a sacred goblin relic. Rumor has it that it now rests in her sarcophagus, in a tomb accessible only by wizard kind. Ranrok and I had a falling out a while back. The relic could well repair the chasm between us.
If I retrieve the relic, how do I know you'll tell me the truth about what Ranrok says?
We will have to trust each other. I, that you will not abscond with the relic, and you, that I'll share what I learn. Gather whatever supplies you may need, and meet me near the witch's tomb.
I'm ready.
Good. There's no time to lose.
What precisely is the relic I'm to retrieve?
A valuable heirloom known as the Helmet of Urtgot.
The witch considered herself a collector and purchased the helmet as a trinket. She cared not what pain she caused the goblins. Goblins believe that the rightful owner of any object is its maker, not its purchaser.
Wizard kind see things differently. It's a wonder goblins and wizards have ever been able to work together.
The differences between our kinds are myriad.
They seem to be.
It may surprise you to know that I do not believe those differences always to be insurmountable. It is the reason I find myself traveling with you to this tomb today.
Ah, and there it is. The witch's tomb.
Dreadful looking place, isn't it?
I wish you luck retrieving the helmet. As a wand carrier, you should have an advantage. Now, before you set off, do you have any questions?
What about this helmet makes it so special?
The helmet of Urtgot is an ancient and storied relic, forged during a time of unity among the goblin clans. It inspired greatness, that is, until it was no longer ours. Then it became something else. A symbol of what has been lost, of all that wizardkind has taken from us. Reclaiming it would mean a great deal to goblinkind and to Ranrok. He would be grateful to me should I return it.
Don't suppose you have any idea what could be waiting for me inside the tomb?
Considering a dark witch was involved, I suppose there's a chance you may encounter the Dark Protectors, known as Inferi. The foul creatures thrive on darkness and the cold. Vanquish them with light, force, and most effectively, fire.
It all seems clear to me now that we're here.
I do hope our alliance proves fruitful. Again, I wish you luck. I will remain here, eagerly awaiting your return. Please. Be careful.
Sealed. Moths. Curious.
Lumos.
Merlin's beard.
Revelio.
This can't be the witch's tomb. Likely I need to go further.
Lumos. Lumos. Lumos.
I have a feeling I'm not alone here.
Revelio. Revelio. If I could power it somehow, it looks like it could be rotated. This has a moth. Same as the door.
Lumos. Lumos. Lumos.
I see this is supposed to spin. But how?
Lumos. Revelio.
Lumos. Lumos.
Leviosa. Leviosa. Accio.
I know. Depulso should set this spinning. Lumos. Lumos. What's that hanging there? Looks precarious.
Revelio. Accio.
Down I go. No other way.
Revelio. Revelio. Levioso. Accio. Revelio. Revelio. Thank you. Lumos. Looks even more complex. Lumos. Making this spin ought to raise that platform. Lumos. Lumos.
Lumos. Lumos.
The witch's final resting place. Lodgok said the helmet was in her sarcophagus.
Rebellion.
A dead Ashwinder. Your compatriots must have made off with the helmet. Lord Gok won't like this. To show this to Lodgok. There must be some sort of mechanism for this doorway. Lodgok, the sarcophagus had been raided. I found no helmet, only a dead Ashwinder.
Damn! They got here first! We need to get it before Rookwood uses it to further ingratiate himself to Ranrok. I saw one of their campsites not far from here, but I fear you must go in alone. My fighting days are behind me.
I'll head there now.
Good. There's no time to lose. Get to that helmet before Rookwood does, or we will lose our chance at any leverage, no matter how small, with Ranrok. To think those wretched thieves have their eyes on such a relic.
You will pay for
this. You're easier to spot than an erumpant. Aha! Back.
Cost us our ransom. We had that money with Incendio.
Stupid.
Incendio!
every time. I've got some flowers at your grave.
Ashwander, no less. Revelio.
Revelio. That's it.
This is for Rookwood!
Oh, try not to make this too strong. Pay for your deed. No, you can't hold out for us. You've made a great mistake.
Looks rather dark in there. Never stopped me before.
I retrieved the helmet from the Ashwinders.
Well done! This is sure to impress Ranrok. The helmet shines even more brightly than I imagined. The etchings, the contour of the profile, remarkable.
It looks stunning, Lodgok. I see why you wanted it back.
You did the thieves a service by recovering it. I know many a goblin who would have killed for it.
Ah, then I am glad to be rid of it myself.
Thank you. This should earn Ranrok's trust. I will take it to him immediately. It may distract him from his search.
His search?
It is merely an inkling. You have impressed me greatly, friend. I am glad that I trusted you. We shall speak soon. Best to keep our arrangement quiet for now. Many will not believe that our aims might possibly be aligned.
There we go. Could it be a Merlin trial? That's it.
Welcome back. Have you finished?
Reporting back, Professor. Assignment's all finished.
Well done. Shows good discipline. Wisdom is a golden snitch, as they say. And you're proving a skilled seeker in that regard. Let us practice our restore momentum. A charm, incidentally, created to stop Quaffles from plummeting straight to the ground during a Quidditch match. Precise, deliberate movements. Very good. That's it. Keep it up.
Professor, do you have a moment?
Yes, what is it?
In class, I heard you mention the Toyohashi Quidditch team.
I did. The Toyohashi Tengu are from Japan. Dominant, known for their rigorous training. They practice near the Mahutokoro School of Magic, often battling both tempestuous seas and violent storms, in addition to each other. Tournament play is almost always easier for the Tengu than their training sessions.
I take it you're a fan.
Fan? I was being groomed to play on their team. And I would have been a Tengu, if not for a bit of bad luck.
If you were that good, I can't believe a bit of bad luck could end your entire Quidditch career.
I was excellent. My ability on a broom had nothing to do with what happened. I was betrayed by someone I trusted. Myself. I did not see clearly and I paid a dear price. My best friend Asuka and I were being groomed to play on the team together. I as keeper and she as chaser. She was breathtaking. She once corkscrewed through three players and scored before they even turned their heads. But as tryouts for the Tengu got closer, she panicked. I did not realize the extent of her panic until it was too late. She wanted so desperately for both of us to play together that she had slipped Felix Felicis into our tea before we were to show them our skills.
Liquid luck? That's illegal, isn't it?
It is indeed. I knew within minutes that something was different. I had never played so well. And Asuka was playing more beautifully than I had ever seen. When I confronted her afterwards, she admitted what she had done. I withdrew from consideration immediately.
But it wasn't your fault. You didn't know about the potion in the tea.
It does not matter. My flying that day was not my own. I could not live with myself. So, I withdrew and explained to them why. I burned my broom in disgrace.
What happened to Asuka? Did she burn her broom as well?
Asuka played for the Tengu for two seasons.
You didn't report her? Tell them what she'd done?
Her fate was not mine to decide. My fate is in my hands, as your fate is in yours.
Thank you, Professor. I shall remember what you've told me.
Convenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Revelio. risk leaving things in the dormitory without a muggle turning charm.
Rebellion.